So you know now Khejdi is releasing in Thailand, I think the first Indian LGBTQ film to release in Thailand first, and then of course it will be having an India release. So how excited you people, and how did this happen that it is getting a release in Thailand first and not in India first? Tell us something about that.
Oh, this again has a very nice and interesting story to it, as we had the world premiere of Khejdi in India, which was at Ashish International Goa Film Festival on the 24th of May 2018. And at that point of time, this company from Thailand, it is called Jakin Global Media PLC, which are the one of the biggest content syndicating company from Thailand. So they buy a lot of content from India. They wanted to meet Ashish, and we happened to invite them for the premiere. Unfortunately, they couldn't come for the premiere because they missed their flight, and they came the next day. So we met the CEO of the company. Her name is Anne, and we had no idea who are we meeting, and we just met, and we said, okay, fine, we'll keep a screening for you. And she wanted to see the film, and when she saw the film, and she was like, wow, what is this? And then we got to know that she is herself is a trans woman, and we had no idea. And she's like, you know, I'm so touched. And she was just like, I'm so touched watching this film, because you know, Ashish has exactly portrayed me, and it's coincidentally it is her life story as well. And she was like, you know, I want to present this film worldwide, because this is a story which needs to be said and which needs to be seen. And this is the way, you know, everything got into place. And then she decided, you know, that I'll do a theatrical release of this film in Thailand, because she wanted to show this film to the world, to Thailand fans, and B, Ashish has a lot of big base in as fans in Thailand,
internationally.
Yeah. So then she's like, you know, it will be a treat to the audience as well, to the Thai fans as well. So that is why it came into picture like this, that the film is first getting released in Thailand and then it comes to India.
So when are you guys planning to release it in India?
We'll have to still figure out. We are not sure whether we do a theatrical release or we go for an OTT platform. We get to figure out that.
Coming to OTT platform, Ashish, I think you have done everything now, films, television, OTT. You played Narendra Modi. How was that experience of playing that character? Because as you said, like for Khejdi, you didn't have any reference. But when it comes to Mr. Narendra Modi, we have seen him. Yeah. So how was it playing that character?
See, again, very interestingly, for Modi also, I had no reference point. Because the era that I portrayed, that era is not documented at all. And I played in from, let's say, 20 to 40, 45, till the time he became the chief minister of Gujarat for the first time. And that was the making of a politician, making of an individual, you know, his coming of age, or you can say the way he was modeled, or he took inspirations from, and how life in general, the kind of life he lived, helped him groom into this magnanimous leader that we see today. So for that, I had no reference point. I had just some few pictures here and there, and that's about it, because the whole journey was not documented. So, but what interestingly we had were anecdotes from the friends, from family, from you know, his peer group was still alive, and so the research team met them, spoke to them, got to know a lot of stories about him. So from there we picked up a lot of stuff. From there I picked up a lot of stuff, and I think the only thing that I had a reference of was how he talks and how his mannerisms are, because they wouldn't change that much, because that's a very individual personal trait. So I tried to capture that, and again, for that also today what we see is like years of public speaking and years of public exposure, and he has a habit of grooming himself every single day. That's a very interesting habit that he has. He keeps grooming himself, he keeps learning, and so you will see, you know, in his speeches also, you know, over the period of time he has groomed, there's a finesse that has come into him now. And so I had to deconstruct that completely in my mind, and how raw it would be when he was young. And but those simple gestures would be raw. They wouldn't be, you know, that definite. They wouldn't be with finesse. Today he has a certain pause. He has, you know, he'll take certain pauses. We know that, you know, that he's going to pause here, and then he's going to wait for the reaction, and then he's going to talk again. But when he was young, when he was just a normal party worker or an RSS worker, he wouldn't do that. You know, he would just be raw. So I had to deconstruct that in my head and keep that in mind, that if it will get refined, it will reach there. So yeah, and that was the whole preparation about it. But it was a lot of fun doing that. Amazing fun I had.
Absolutely, I would love to, and we've been wanting to do that for a really long time, I think, because the Thailand FC has been doing really, really wonderful job there since past 3 years or something, and they have always have a charity program going on running, and they make these nice my caricatures, and then they sell those souvenirs and
t-shirts,
collect money from it for the charity, and I think this time they're doing it for the stray dogs.